हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स लर्न साइंस सब्जेक्ट स्टैंडर्ड 8 चैप्टर 9 रिप्रोडक्शन इन एनिमल्स। रिप्रोडक्शन इज एसेंशियल वाई फॉर द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ स्पीशीज। What does reproduction do? It ensures the continuation of similar kinds of individuals generation after generation. We have learned in the previous chapter about the plants, how plants reproduce. Right now, in this chapter, we shall learn about the animals, how the animals reproduce. What are the modes of reproduction? यू नो हाउ द चिक्स आर बॉर्न। चिक्स मतलब जो हैन होती है मुर्गी, उसमें से बच्चे कैसे आते हैं, एग्स कैसे आते हैं, उसके बारे में हम लोग पढ़ेंगे। ठीक है, देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन। फर्स्ट वन इज सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एंड अदर वन इज असेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। नाउ लेट्स लर्न अबाउट सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। You remember that plants that reproduce sexually have male and female reproductive parts, right? If you remember in earlier chapter we have learned about the plant reproduction. In animals also same type of reproduction happens in sexual reproduction. Like plants, in animals, in female gametes form a zygote after meeting a sperm. It is the zygote which develops into a new individual. We will learn about this in detail. This type of reproduction beginning from the fusion of male and female gametes is called sexual reproduction. Right? Whenever the fusion of male and female gametes, it is called sexual reproduction. Now let's learn about the male reproductive organ. The male reproductive organ include a pair of testes, two sperm ducts and a penis. Singular, it is called testes. What is produced? continue to develop. That means it will continue to grow. It gradually develops the body parts such as hands, legs, head, ears, etc. That is, all body parts continue to form. The stage of the embryo in which all the body parts can be identified is called a fetus. In which you can identify, that means you can come to know that the embryo is developing. When the development of the fetus is complete, the mother gives birth to a baby. When the development, that means when the fetus is completely developed into a full grown baby, the mother will give birth to that child. Now you know that internal fertilization also takes place in hens, but hens do not give babies, right? They give eggs, right? And from the eggs, their babies are developed. Let's see how the hens give birth to the babies. Soon after fertilization, the zygote divides repeatedly and travels down the oviduct. As it travels down, many protective layers are formed around it. The hard shell that you see in a hen's egg is one such protective layer. We have seen that egg, right? It has a hard white covering. So that is a protective layer which is formed. After the hard shell is formed around the developing embryo, the hen finally lays the eggs. The embryo takes about 3 weeks to develop into a chick. You must have seen that hen which sits on the eggs. When it sits, the egg is little bit warm. Because of the body of the hen, the egg will get warmth and then it will develop into a chick, right? The development of the chick takes place inside the shell. After the chick is completely developed, it bursts open the eggshell. When the chick is fully formed, break the shell of the egg and it will come out. In animals which undergo external fertilization, development of the embryo takes place outside the female body. The embryos continue to grow within their egg covering. After the embryo develops, the eggs hatch. You must have seen numerous tadpoles swimming in ponds and streams. We have read this earlier. The female, what it will do, it will lay its eggs on the surface of water. The male frog will come and it will deposit all its sperms all over the surface. And due to the mating, they will develop into a embryo. Now let's learn about viviparous and oviparous animals. The animals which give birth to young ones are called viviparous, and the animals which lay eggs are called oviparous animals. जो अंडी देते हैं उनको oviparous बोलते हैं, और जिनका बच्चा जन्म होता है उनको viviparous बोलते हैं, right? मतलब जो human beings हैं, they are viviparous, okay? Because they give birth to the young ones. They do not lay eggs. The animals from which you can collect eggs, they are oviparous, okay? So all the aquatic animals, most of them are which type of animals? They are oviparous animals, okay? The new individuals which are born or hatched from the egg continue to grow till they become adults. Once they become adults, the growth will stop. In some animals, the young ones may look very different from adults. Right? When the babies are grown fully into adults, there will be changes in their features. Now let's recall the life cycle of a silkworm. First, eggs are there. From eggs, larva is developed, and from larva, caterpillar is formed, and from caterpillar, a pupa is made, and from a pupa, it is grown into an adult. Okay, these are the stages of the silkworm. Now the age from egg to the full grown frog is like this. First eggs are there, then it is grown into a tadpole, you can call it larva, and then it is fully grown into an adult. From this life cycle you can easily differentiate. See how the eggs look like. Then the early tadpole looks how it is totally different from the eggs. Then we will see the later tadpole. How are the features of these, right? And after this, the fully grown adult frog is formed. So the features are continuously changing till it grows into an adult. The features that are present in the adult are not found in the young ones. A beautiful moth comes out from the cocoon, and in case of tadpoles, they transform into adults capable of jumping and swimming. The tail which we saw in the tadpole will disappear when it turns into a full grown frog. The transformation of the larva into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. Now if we differentiate between humans and animals, in humans the body parts similar to which are present during the time of birth, they are also present when we are grown into adults, right? Now let's learn about asexual reproduction. So far we have learned about reproduction in some familiar animals. Now we will learn about asexual. What does it mean? In asexual reproduction, only a single parent is involved, right? Now let's see this. This is the diagram of a microorganism of a water. The name is Hydra. Take the sample of a Hydra and observe them under microscope. You will see bulges from this parent body, right? And you have to count the number of bulges you see in different sides. And also see, this is the bulge from this body, right? This is the small bulge that it is developing, right? So you just note it down, how many bulges are there, and then you draw the diagram of this Hydra after seeing in the microscope. In each Hydra there may be one or more bulges. These bulges are the developing individuals, and they are called buds. These are the developing individuals and they are called buds. Recall the presence of buds in yeast. In yeast also the similar type of buds are there. Okay. In Hydra too, the new individuals develop as outgrowths from a single parent. From a single parent only it is grown into a individual. This type of reproduction in which only a single parent is involved is called asexual reproduction. Since new individuals develop from the buds in Hydra, this type of asexual reproduction is called budding. So only a single parent is involved in this, from which the bud is formed, and this type of reproduction is called budding. Another method of asexual reproduction is observed in the macroscopic organism, amoeba. Let's see how it happens. It begins the process of reproduction by the division of its nucleus into two nuclei. Its nucleus will divide into two nuclei. This is followed by the division of its body into two. Yeah, it is a whole one body and then it is developing into two. Finally, two amoeba are produced from one parent amoeba. This type of asexual reproduction, in which an animal reproduces by dividing into two individuals, is called binary fusion. Binary fission means one adult is there and it is dividing itself into two parts. So it is called binary fission. Apart from budding and binary fission, there are other methods by which a single parent reproduces the young one. We'll study this in the higher classes. With this, chapter number 9 is complete.